Good afternoon, students. This is Rachna, Assistant Professor, Community Health Nursing in Metro College of Nursing. So today we will discuss about a procedure in community, that is urine analysis. How do we analyze urine in community? How we take the sample and then test it by various methods. Okay. What is urine analysis? Urine analysis is one of the oldest laboratory procedures in the practice of medicine. It is also known as urine R&M, routine and microscopy. It is an array of tests performed on urine and one of the most common investigation to rule out any disorder or disease. So what are the purposes? Why do we do this urine analysis? Okay, first is a general evaluation of health. Second is diagnosis of disease or disorders of the kidneys or urinary tract. Third is diagnosis of other systemic diseases that affect kidney function. Fourth is monitoring of patients with diabetes. We have to rule out any sugar in urine. Okay. Then fifth is screening for drug abuse. For example, sulfonamide or aminoglycosides. Okay. Then collection of urine specimen. This is very important step. This is collection of urine specimen. How to collect urine specimen? So improper collection can result in invalidate results. Okay, so take care while you are collecting the urine specimen. The containers for collection of urine should be wide mouthed, clean and dry, and it must be analyzed within 2 hours of collection, else it requires refrigeration. So what are the types of urine sample we take generally? So for routine screening or chemical examination and FEME. FEME stands for full examination microscopy examination. ठीक है, तो इनके लिए क्या करते हैं, हम random specimen लेते हैं. We have to take random specimen for routine screening or chemical examination and FEME. तो so sampling is done with no specific time. It is the most common sample type we have taken. We take usually and it is taken any time of the day. No specific time of taking this sample. Okay, that is why it is called as random specimen. Second is morning sample. Morning sample is taken for the first urine in the morning, and it is most concentrated at that time, and the purpose is to test pregnancy and microscopic test. Then third is clean catch midstream. In that we discard first few milliliters and collect the rest, and it is done for culture, urine culture. Okay, then next is 24 hour specimen. So the sampling is done, like all the urine passed during the day and night, and the next day first sample is collected. Okay, after 24 hours first sample collect kiya jata hai. Okay, the purpose is used for quantitative and qualitative analysis of substances. Then next is postprandial. It is done or taken 2 hours after meal, and it is used to monitor glucose in diabetic conditions. Then sample type next is suprapubic aspirated. Suprapubic aspirated is done through needle aspiration, and the purpose is to obtain sterile urine. Okay, so in image A you can see this is the clean catch urine collection method in children. Okay, Then in image B, you can see this is the suprapubic aspiration of urine. डायरेक्टली जो है ब्लैडर से यूरिन लिया जा रहा है. उसके बाद है व्हाट आर द मेथड्स. दे आर मेनली फोर टाइप्स ऑफ मेथड और फोर टाइप्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट्स वी डू इन यूरिन एनालिसिस. फर्स्ट इज मैक्रोस्कोपिक और फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन. सेकेंड इज केमिकल एग्जामिनेशन. थर्ड इज माइक्रोस्कोपिक एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द सेडिमेंट. And fourth is urine culture. Okay, so in physical examination we examine the gross appearance like volume, color, odor. In microscopy we examine the cells, casts, crystals, bacteria. And in urine culture or chemical examination, we can say. In chemical examination, we measure the pH, osmolality, protein, urea, creatinine, glucose. Okay? उसके बाद आता है हमारा. अब हम community में जो पढ़ते हैं, what we do is basically physical examination of urine. Okay? जो हमें आज procedure पढ़ना है, हम किसके बारे में पढ़ेंगे? Physical examination of urine and chemical examination of urine. So, in physical examination of urine, the urine is characterized by volume, color, odor, pH and specific gravity. So, volume we can measure, color we can see, we can observe, odor we can smell, and pH value we can and specific gravity we can measure by pH strips and reagent strips or refractometer. Okay, so volume, the normal volume of urine is 1 to 2.5 liter per day. In case of oliguria, urine output is less than 400 ml per day, and it can be commonly seen in cases of dehydration, shock, acute glomerulonephritis, renal failure. Second, polyuria. Polyuria means more than normal value. Urine output is more than 2.5 liter per day, and it is seen in increased water ingestion or diabetes mellitus and insipidus. Then anuria. Anuria is when urine output is less than 100 ml per day, and it is seen in renal shutdown or renal failure. Then color. The normal color of urine is pale yellow due to pigments urochrome, urobilin and uroerythrin. The cloudiness may be caused by excessive cellular material or protein, crystallization or precipitation of non-pathological salts upon standing at room temperature or in the refrigerator. Then color of urine depending upon its constituents. So abnormal colors, what we commonly seen in abnormal cases is colorless urine, deep yellow urine, blue green urine, this pink, orange, red color, red brown, black color. Okay, so colorless urine we can see in cases of diabetes and diuretics. Then deep yellow, it is seen in concentrated urine or excess bile pigments or in case of jaundice. Blue green color is seen in when methylene blue dye comes out in urine, or pseudomonas in urine, riboflavin in urine. Then pink, orange, red color we can see if there is hemoglobin in urine, myoglobin, phenolphthalein, porphyrins and rifampicin. If we take rifampicin, the color of the urine will be pink, orange, red. Then red, brown, black in case of hemoglobin, myoglobin, RBCs, homogentisic acid, L-DOPA, melanin, methyl-DOPA. In case of some drugs or medicines, the color of the urine can be changed. Okay. Then odor. Odor, normal odor of urine is aromatic due to volatile fatty acids. on long standing, the order of the urine changed to ammonical, decomposition of urea forming ammonia, which gives a strong ammonical smell in urine. Then there can be you can smell the foul or offensive smell in case of pus or inflammation or in case of UTI. Okay, sweet smell in case of diabetes, fruity in case of ketonuria. Then maple syrup like smell in case of maple syrup urine disease, rancid or you can say foul smell in case of tyrosine anemia. Then rotten egg odor in case of presence of sulfur in urine. Then pH value. pH value in urine, the pH ranges from 4.5 to 8. Okay. So the pH value reflects ability of kidney to maintain normal hydrogen ion concentration in plasma and extracellular fluid. Normally, it is slightly acidic, lying between 6 to 6.5, and it can be tested by, this pH value in urine can be tested by litmus paper, pH paper, dipsticks. Okay, acidic urine we can see in case of ketosis, diabetes, starvation, fever. Okay, then systemic acidosis or UTI, Duke E. coli, and acidification therapy. Then specific gravity. Specific gravity, it is measurement of urine density, which reflects the ability of kidney to concentrate or dilute the urine relative to the plasma from which it is filtered. So it is measured by urinometer, refractometer, and dipsticks. In normal jo specific gravity hoti hai urine mein, that is 1.001 to 1.040. okay, if there is increase in specific gravity, this can be seen in case of low water intake, diabetes mellitus, albuminuria, acute nephritis. Then if there is decrease in specific gravity, you can see in case of absence of ADH, renal tubular damage. If there is fixed specific gravity, then it will be 1.010. okay, that is normal. So you can see these three tools of measurement of specific gravity in urine: medical refractometer, urinometer, and urine dipsticks. Okay, then chemical analysis of urine. So we have talked about, I have discussed about physical analysis of urine. Okay, so in that we what we measure is volume, okay, intake output chart we can maintain for that. Then order, then color, then pH value, then specific gravity. Now coming to chemical analysis of urine. Chemical analysis of urine is undertaken to evaluate the levels of following components. There is some spelling mistake, excuse me for that. This urine is, not us, and following components, not component. Okay, so what are those components we can evaluate? These are protein, glucose, ketones, occult blood, bilirubin, urobilinogen, bile salts. But here in community health nursing procedure, we will talk only about protein and glucose, sugar and albumin. Okay, so the presence of normal and abnormal chemical elements in the urine are detected using dry reagent strips called dipsticks. When the test strip is dipped in urine, the reagents are activated and a chemical reaction occurs. The chemical reaction results in a specific color change. After a specific amount of time has elapsed, this color change is compared against a reference color chart provided. Like this. Okay, we dip this dipstick in urine, then match the color, then we will wait for some time, color will change, and we match the color with dipstick chart. Okay, like this. There are some values, there are some so what all articles are required to do the urine analysis in community? First is container for specimen, Benedict solution, acetic acid, test tubes and holder, kidney tray, paper bag, spirit lamp with spirit, newspaper, matchbox, cotton balls in a bowl. Apart from that, what all tests you are doing? For sugar, you need Benedict solution or reagent strips or dipsticks. Okay, and also you can do the sugar test with Fehling solution A and B, so you will require that also. And in case of this albumin, you can do hot test as well as cold test. So you will need acetic acid and also you will need nitric acid. Okay, so you will require all these articles, including your bag, including that gloves and documentation articles also. So what are the procedure? Select a proper place, spread the newspaper, then unbutton the bag, then take out hand washing articles and wash the hands, then take out the kidney tray and specimen bottle and gives the specimen bottle to the client for collecting urine. Take the articles required for the test. Okay, then firstly you will do the test for sugar. So in Benedict's test, we have to pour 5 ml of Benedict solution in the test tube, then boil it to find out the color change. If no change, that shows the purity of Benedict solution. Add 8 drops of urine into solution and reheat it and allow it to cool. Then observe the color change, which indicates the sugar level. Blue indicates 0% sugar, green 1%, yellow 2%, orange 3%, and brick red 5%. You can also measure it like that. Blue solution, nil sugar. Green solution, more than less than 500 milligram per deciliter. Green PPT, 500 to 1000 mg per dl. Yellow PPT, 1000 to 1500 mg per dl. Orange PPT precipitations, 1500 to 2000 mg per dl. Red brick red precipitations, more than 2000 mg per dl of glucose. Okay, now coming to urine for albumin hot test. For this, you have to take urine up to 2/3 of the test tube and heat the upper 1/3. Rotate test tube constantly, then add few drops of acetic acid along the sides of the test tube and observe for precipitation. If the cloud disappears, it is due to phosphate. If the cloud still remains, it indicates the presence of albumin. It will not disappear with acetic acid. If the clouds will remain same, then there is albumin present in the urine. If urine is highly acidic or highly alkaline, the reading will be false. So in cold test of albumin, add 2 ml of sulfosalicylic acid or nitric acid to 2 ml of urine in a test tube. If albumin is present, white precipitate will be seen where two fluids meet. Protein is indicated by cloudy precipitate. So before termination of articles, let's have a quick watch for a short video. You can easily understand the procedure through this video. So let's have a quick watch for this video.
Sugar in urine. Benedict's test. Materials required: test tube, test tube holder, urine sample, measuring cylinders, Benedict's solution, and burner. Procedure: take 2 ml urine sample in a measuring cylinder from the urine sample bottle. Take a test tube and pour the urine sample in it. Take 5 ml Benedict's reagent in a measuring cylinder. Add Benedict's reagent to the test tube that contains urine sample. Using a test tube holder, hold the test tube firmly and heat it for 2 minutes on the burner. Keep shaking the test tube while heating. A yellow precipitate appears, which indicates the presence of sugar in urine. Depending upon the concentration of sugar in the urine, either green, yellow, or brick red precipitates are formed. Fellings test. Materials required: test tube holder, urine sample, measuring cylinders, Fellings solution A, Fellings solution B, and burner. Procedure: take 2 ml urine sample in a measuring cylinder from the urine sample bottle. Take a test tube and pour the urine sample in it. Take 2 ml Fellings solution A in a measuring cylinder. Add Fellings solution A to the test tube that contains the urine sample. Take 2 ml Fellings solution B in a measuring cylinder. Add Fellings solution B to the test tube that contains the urine sample. Using a test tube holder, hold the test tube firmly and heat it gently for 2 minutes on the burner. Keep shaking the test tube while heating. A green precipitate appears, which indicates the presence of traces of sugar in urine. Depending upon the concentration of sugar in the urine, either green, yellow, or brick red precipitates are formed. Detection of albumin in urine. Sulfosalicylic acid test. Materials required: test tube, dropper, test tube holder, urine sample, measuring cylinders, 30% sulfosalicylic acid, and burner. Procedure: take 2 ml urine sample in a measuring cylinder from the urine sample bottle. test tube and pour the urine in the test tube. Using a dropper, take some sulfosalicylic acid. Add a few drops of sulfosalicylic acid in the test tube containing urine. A whitish color appears in the solution. Using a test tube holder, hold the test tube firmly and heat it gently upon a burner. A whitish or cloudy turbid solution indicates the presence of albumin in the urine sample. Heller's test. Materials required: test tube, dropper, test tube holder, urine sample, measuring cylinders, and concentrated nitric acid. Procedure: take 5 ml concentrated nitric acid in a measuring cylinder from the reagent bottle. Concentrated nitric acid in a test tube from the measuring cylinder. Using a dropper, take some urine from the urine sample bottle. Now, incline the test tube and add sample of urine by means of a dropper along the inner side of the test tube so that it forms a layer over the nitric acid. The presence of white ring at the junction of two layers indicates the presence of albumin in the urine.
I hope you will better understand with these short videos of the procedure. So now, after you have analyzed the urine for sugar and albumin, now termination of the articles, this is very important step. After the procedure, it is essential to terminate the articles in a proper manner. After the result, recording and reporting, dispose the urine sample as well as the liquid from the used test tubes. Take the articles to the hand washing area. Wash each article clearly. Put the articles on newspaper for drying up and wash your hands with soap and water. Now give health education. Wipe all the articles with spirit swab before placing them into the bag. After wiping and replace all the articles into the bag, close the chain or buckle and pick up the bag. Fold the newspaper and place it in the outer pocket. So this is all about today's topic, that is urine analysis in community, how to take the sample and how to analyze this urine samples for sugar and albumin. So these are the video links for the procedure which I have shown you during the this recording. So that's all. Thank you. If any query, you can ask me anytime. Thank you so much.